my kids always joke with me about. And I just want to say thank you so very, very much to our Air Force Junior ROTC staff and the cadets for inviting me to be here today and speak on such an honor and a special occasion. I was in the Army for 4 years, and I can tell you that without any reservations, those are the most proud 4 years I've ever had a chance to serve in my life. And those 4 years taught me things about myself that I would have never had the opportunity to learn had it not been for the armed services. And I can also tell you that there's not a family probably in the United States that hasn't been affected in one way or another by the United States Armed Services, or have had a member in it, or even had a member that has fallen in battle and had to feel that loss. So again, I want to say that it's today that we take this opportunity to honor those that have gone before us and honor those that will go ahead of us. And I can't think of a better way to do that than with a ceremony like this today. And I was in the United States Army Band, so I can't tell you how many services that I did just like this. This is primarily my job, was to put on ceremony honoring the United States Army Service. So it brings back a lot of good and fond memories for me today to be here and watch these young men and young ladies put on this service. So again, you guys have done an outstanding job. I wanted to keep my speech relatively short. It's a little chilly this morning, but I thought it's quite fitting because it's just enough chill in the air to be slightly uncomfortable. So I think it reminds us that the men and women that serve in our military are oftentimes put in slightly